Hello, welcome. My name is Robert Mazurek, and I warmly welcome you to the Mr. Battery channel. Since this episode will be quite packed with specific data from my research and tests on this charger, the introduction will definitely be shorter. I wanted to present to you a charger that, in my opinion, is one of the most popular chargers in Poland, because whenever I have the pleasure of talking to my clients who come in, they ask about battery service. What and how to do it properly, or why this battery is weaker and struggles to start. I often ask what device they are using to charge, and a significant portion of them, in fact a very large portion of these customers, tell me that they use a charger from Lidl, or alternatively refer to it as a charger from Ladybug. Is this charger with the symbol ULGD 5.0 and the designation A1 worth buying? You will find out in this episode. I would like to demonstrate this charger to you in the most objective way possible, which is why I bought this charger through the Lidl online store, paying 65 PLN gross for it. As I talk to my clients in Szczecin from the World of Batteries company, I conclude that a significant portion of charger car and battery users in these vehicles are people who use diesel-powered vehicles. Therefore, to test this charger, I will use a 74AA 680A cold cranking amp battery, which is a typical Chan diesel battery in an L3 case, measuring 278/175 mm at the base, and a height of 190 m. Which is 19 cm, right? Plus a typical WAG group. In fact, the most popular battery in terms of sales in this casing in my company for many years has been this type of battery. This charger offers us two modes when it comes to voltages. We can charge 6V batteries for motorcycles, somewhere where the maximum current according to the manufacturer's declaration will be 0.8A, meanwhile the maximum voltage will be 7.3V. The second mode for motorcycles has a maximum voltage of 14.4V, and the current in this mode will be 0.8A, or 8 to 10 of an ampe. The next mode is the car mode, classic 14.4V 5A, in terms of current intensity, and the star mode 14.7V, with a current intensity of 5A. What's with this asterisk? I'll explain it to you because we often talk about charging with an asterisk, cold charging, winter charging, and so on. It is actually about a concept called temperature compensation, and the closer we get to zero, the more safely we can raise the charging voltage to achieve similar effects as when we charge the battery under laboratory conditions, which is around 25 degrees Celsius. Around 0 degrees, you can confidently raise the charging voltage by 0.3 volts. And regardless of the type of battery technology, this will not cause any damage or losses to the battery. So remember, if a star appears, if there is a question related to charging in winter in cold conditions, you can confidently use it at lower temperatures. And if you are dealing with an acid battery with a liquid electrolyte, where you can hear the electrolyte sloshing around inside, do not use any programs other than those marked with a star. If the programs with a star are the strongest in your charger, then in the case of this charger, the strongest program in terms of current and voltage will be the mode with a star, which will discharge this battery. We will check the density of this battery after the discharge and connect this charger in its maximum mode, recording all charging parameters through the alphabet. A few hours after discharging with the alphabet, this battery has a voltage of 12.15V at a temperature of 20 degrees. It generates 478 amperes according to the N standard for starting current. The density of the electrolyte to which I discharge this battery is 1.16 gram per cubic centimeter. After such a discharge, I unpacked this charger. I connected it properly to the battery. I selected exactly the program I mentioned to you earlier, which is the program with a star, 14.7V as the maximum charging voltage, and 5 amperes of current intensity, which is the maximum current intensity that this charger can generate according to the manufacturer. And here is the effect of this charging. The first thing I like is that the charger charges for 20 hours and 16 minutes. In front of you, you can see a graph showing the course voltage and current. The curve indicating voltage is the upper one with two peaks adjacent to each other, like Everest and Lhotse, separated by the South Col, and at the bottom, that very geometric shape represents the current intensity. The first thing that is surprising is that 5 amperes did not appear when it comes to that current. During this charging, the maximum current that appeared was 2.96 amperes, while the upper voltage recorded by the device was 14.5 volts. The results... And now let's see what the effect is in terms of density. The density is 1.18 grams per cubic centimeter up to 1.28 megafar. As for the electrical parameters at a voltage of 12.93 V and a temperature of 21 degrees Celsius, this battery generates 714 amperes, according to the EN standard. After the first charge, I personally did not expect anything more, as we started with a density of 1.16 and, just like with many electronic chargers, there was no miracle, and this charger did not charge the battery to a density of 1.28 on the first attempt, which is the benchmark in this video, namely in the density challenge. As a result, I connected the charger once again for charging and got involved in completely different matters. The next day when I arrived at Akubis Labo, I saw that this second charging ended very quickly, as it was completed after just 25 minutes, and the maximum voltage recorded by Alphabat during that time was 14.7 V. However, the current intensity did not exceed 0.75 amperes. Quite disappointing. I checked the electrolyte density. The electrolyte density increased by 0.01 to 1.19 grams per cubic centimeter. I also examined the electrical parameters of this battery. They measured 720 amperes at a voltage of 13.16 volts at 21 degrees Celsius. According to the EN standard, this battery generated Celsius 720 amperes according to the standard. This battery generated, since I still haven't been able to achieve the parameter I care about, which is a density of 1.28 grand per cm3, I connected this battery to the Lidl ULGD 5.0 charger for the third time. The charging ended again after 25 minutes, which I only found out the next day. The voltage parameters are also 14.7, and regarding the current intensity parameters, it is also 0.75. Meanwhile, the density increased by another 1/100th, and now amounted to 1.20 grias per cubic centimeter. I connected this charger, and once again, the charging finished in less than half an hour the next day, with the voltage around 14.7, while the current of 0.75 amperes was the maximum current. The density of the electrolyte has jumped again by 0.01, reaching 1.21 gdaltz per cubic centimeter, which made me think that it was time to connect this charger for the fifth time. I connected the charger for the fifth time, and again the charging took less than 25 minutes. The maximum voltage that appeared was 14.7, which is exactly what I expected, but the current is once again 0.75 amperes. The result of all this is a density of 1.21 grams per cubic centimeter. At that moment, I concluded that this experiment would be a failed experiment and that it was essentially just a matter of recording material for you and discussing it. Why such a charger is unlikely to handle a deeply discharged battery, and that in fact it is more of a nice cosmetic gadget if you are not dealing with heavily discharged batteries, so you can safely connect this little charger to your battery for the whole Saturday or even for Saturday and Sunday as you wish. It is known that it will charge your battery to some extent. It is clear that the effects won't be overwhelming or shocking for you, but you will have the peace of mind that you have done something to stimulate your battery, to charge it a little, or as I often say, to fund the drop of your battery. I didn't have an idea yet on how to present the results to you, but as I was leaving the lab, I decided to disconnect the Alphabat, disconnect all the recording devices, and at the last minute I said, I'll connect this charger and we'll see what it shows in the morning the next day. But it happened that the issues of vacations, the issues of holidays, I got absorbed in work at the World of Batteries company on Grafinska, and the next time I drove to Labo Akubis was only after a week. To my surprise, I saw that this charger was still in charging mode. The voltage indicated by the charger was 14.4 V. I also used a clamp meter to check the current parameters, and it turned out that it was charging at 110 mA, which is 0.11 amperes. And I immediately set about checking the density, and to my surprise I saw a density of 1.24 g per cubic centimeter. And then I discovered why this happened, why those previous charges were not effective compared to what happened now. The Alphabat has a function that if it does not see either an increase in voltage or an increase in current, and instead observes that these parameters are starting to drop, after 10 minutes it concludes that nothing will happen and disconnects such a subject from the ability to record further parameters. Considering that I only popped into the office for a moment to Akubis Labo, I decided that since I already have these parameters after 7 days, I would leave it for the next few days. After 10 days, I checked in at Akubi's lab again, and the voltage was already 14.7 V, while the current was 130 mA. I checked the density, and it was 1.26 G per cm3. This information gave me hope that there might be a chance to reach 1.28, so I left that pair again for a few more days. And returning to Akubi's labo, 14 days, exactly 14 days from that first connection, after those disappointing initial results, I took a look. The voltage was still 14.7 V, while the current intensity was quite low, ranging from 0.02 to 0.09 A. The density was exactly what I expected, which is 1.28 G per cubic centimeter. This battery waited for another 2 days, and then I checked it again from an electrical perspective. At a voltage of 12.91 V and a temperature of plus 24 degrees C, this battery generates 740 A according to the EN standard. Of course, even if we skip the first stage. The stage of those five charges that I recorded through Alpha Beta, we reached a density of 1.28 over the course of 2 weeks. Disadvantages? Advantages? As for the advantages, this charger costs 65 PLN. That is a very significant advantage. Another major advantage is that if you have a lot of time and do not need the car, this charger will do the job in about 2 weeks, with a very deeply discharged battery taking about a week. With a slightly discharged battery, or if you have small batteries such as those for toy motorcycles, the charging will definitely be faster. As for the drawbacks, I did not notice 5 amperes in any charging at any moment. I will have to examine this charger very closely to understand what is going on, because I expected that the 5 amperes should appear. In particular, if we have a very discharged battery, the current intensity increases significantly at first. Meanwhile, the voltage rises slowly, and later, as the voltage increases and the battery starts to accept more and more current, the intensity begins to drop. I did not notice those 5 amperes here. The charging parameters promised by this manufacturer were not registered by me at any point or to any extent. The downside and the upside is that it does not finish charging. For a person who is very aware, who knows what device they have, who understands what that device will or will not do, let's say this could be a slight advantage. However, you, dear user, if you would like to keep this little charger for a longer period so it can take care of your battery, for example, during the winter, I fear that you might find a dry battery. It has only just occurred to me that 2 or 3 times I received information that a customer, after a winter period, upon connecting the charger to the battery to maintain it, discovered that the battery was dry after the whole period. I don't remember now if it's really about the Lidl charger or if it's about any other charger. However, remember that if you want to leave the battery connected to the charger in buffer mode, make sure that this charger will operate within the range of 13.5 to 13.8 V. As for the voltage, it will only activate when the voltage parameters start to drop on the battery or exactly as the manufacturer designed it. Is it worth buying or not? Personally, I am in favor of effectiveness when it comes to charging because I would like to connect the battery, whether it is very deeply discharged, I don't know, on Friday afternoon and have it ready by Sunday afternoon, or if it is only slightly discharged, I would like to connect the battery, I don't know, on Saturday afternoon and have it ready for Sunday morning, or as it will be in the morning test, we connect it after work and the next morning we should have the battery charged. In my opinion, this charger does not meet those criteria. It's a really cool gimmick to get you to buy it. However, claiming that this charger can handle batteries from 1.2 to 128A is wishful thinking. These are pious wishes. Now this charger will go to our friend Titus, who will disassemble the charger, check if he can improve this German engineering idea, and we will see what he does with the charger. You will definitely see it again, and maybe Titus will do such a tuning that this charger will become something amazing. Specializing in tuning chargers for a few zlotys. We will see. If you like the episode, leave a like. If the topics discussed on the Mr. Battery channel appeal to you, don't forget to subscribe. It is important information for the creator that what they are doing makes sense. Best regards from Szczecin, Robert Mazurek. Goodbye.
Do you need support, results, diagnostics, no bore, batteries for the electrical system, quality tests of the best technology? I personally invite you to my YouTube videos.
I will be drilling, twisting, connecting, and testing there, overloading, flooding, and also trying to blow it up. In raising awareness about their quality, the terminology of longevity.
Well, it's Mr. Battery, your navigator, defibrillator. He will explain this issue to you. How different types of batteries are built and how they work. What is Mr. Battery, your navigator, defibrillator, dispels mythological nonsense? and it won't let you choose incorrectly.